We're back talking with dating coach John Keegan and author of Screw Everyone, Sleeping My Way to Monogamy, Ophira Eisenberg. And we are now talking about numbers.
Numbers, yes.
Yes, thank you guys for staying here because this is an important topic.
Yes, I know.
Everyone has their number. It's the number of people that you have slept with. Mm-hmm. And people have issues around that.
They have big issues around it, as it turns out.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, my number, I'm ballparking it at 40, and
are there ones that you're omitting deliberately?
No!
If he was horrible, I don't count him. If it's bad sex, right. It doesn't count.
Oh my, if it was by standards, it would be like 2. No. But, you know, and some people are like, that's a high number. Some people are like, oh, you're an amateur. It really depends on your perspective. But the people that say to me, that's a very high number, or, do you have regrets? I am always like, no. I feel like I have great experience. I'm not shameful about it. I think that I learned a lot of great things from that number.
That's, how about you?
Okay. What about me?
What's your number?
Yeah. Well, I honestly don't know my number.
I
don't know if it's that high. I'm bad at math, you know. But I definitely feel like the number doesn't matter so much. So I keep it secret because I have my own interests. Yes.
Okay, so can I ask you, is it like upwards of 50?
Yeah, I would probably say that. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, I would say around there.
Guys wear those numbers so well.
Yeah, he's like, you're saying numbers. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Well, and that is a weird double standard. Do you not agree that's a weird double standard, though?
But, you know, okay, so it is a weird double standard today, but we've got millennia of women not allowed to sleep with anyone, basically.
That's right.
So we can't expect us to catch up quite that quickly, I think.
But we should try.
We're doing our best effort.
I would say, like, when I was in college, especially, for young men, it was really like a pride to how many women you slept with. And other men it would be a question. You would say, well, how many of you? And it was sort of being judged on that, whereas the opposite was true for women.
Yeah, but with the girl, your girlfriend's number, is that an issue for you?
No, it's not an issue for me at all. And I, in fact, will never ask that question. And when people ask me that question, just like they did here today, I feel like it's one to not get involved in.
So you don't want to know you don't want to talk about her previous sex life at all?
Oh, we could talk about it, you know. As we talk about it, because I think that's fine, you know, when you're comfortable with somebody. But it's just like getting into the numbers, and you have to think of all the jealousy that would go with that, and it's like, why open that can of worms?
Yeah,
that's my thought.
Do you talk about it with your
husband? You know, we never really did, or it wasn't of grave importance. I will say that he has been with less people than me, but it was what I considered reasonable and respectable number. because I actually think if someone said 3, I'd be like, okay, you need to go back into the world for a while. Yeah, I don't want to teach you. But I just think it's so hard to find someone you like. First find someone you like, then worry about these numbers and all that. It's so secondary in my mind.
Do you guys talk about your partner's previous sex lives?
A little bit. It's not my favorite.
Bedtime story.
Exactly.
Tell me about
Lauren again.
Yeah, I would say I don't actually. I mean, I talk about the previous relationship.
Yeah.
But never really do I say, oh, how was it like, you know, having sex with that person or this person? But we'll definitely talk about at times, you know, the relationships, because that always comes up. You know?
Right. Yeah. And it's more. I mean, more important. The thing I would get jealous about would be very superficial and dumb things. Oh, I would be like, oh, did that friend of yours like her better than dumb things that are, you know, inconsequential to them.
Right. Yeah. So then there's no number envy.
Like, no number envy. Right. Yeah. I think anyone who's in triple digits, though, I think that's
do you know anyone?
Exhausting. Yes. People have admitted it to me recently as I've been talking about this. A lot of guys, not going to lie.
Yeah. Really?
A lot of guys.
Men don't really, for in general, men don't see it as something bad. They would actually, you know, one man would say that to another man, and the other man would go, well, you know, it's like, you know, hey, old bull.
So it's a badge of honor?
Yeah, some men really see it that way. Not all men, of course, but in general, that is part of the culture.
See, I think that is so unfair, because I say 40, and people are like, whoa, so you're ashamed about that. I'm like, no!
is there any downside, do you think, to having triple digits, or
even
lots and lots of sexual partners? Do you think, is there any downside, or is it all just a party?
No, I wouldn't say that at all. I mean, I think triple digits, honestly, if I had to draw a line, I think that is excessive. The amount of laundry, like, I can't even imagine how your life would be. It would just be work the whole time.
Yeah.
Keeping in touch, Facebook.
Do you keep in touch with your old lovers?
Some of them. I mean, I can't actually help it with social media.
Oh, no.
I can't help it.
That's
I saw you wrote about me in chapter 3.
Oh, those, yeah, I know, those posts have been coming. Like.
Yeah.
But also, if you have so many numbers, you're talking at that point, it's like, well, what, you know, is this guy very discerning, or is this person very discerning?
That is true.
Which is, you know, that's the only red flag it really puts in my mind. This person's not very discerning. You know, do they, yeah. They'll just, you know, they're just
asleep with anyone.
Are they wearing protection?
Not a good thing to look for it when you're
yeah,
dating.
Yeah, you want to feel like you're with someone. That's the thing, but you want to feel like you're special to someone,
that's
and
true.
What we're having
yeah.
is special and unique. And
that
not
is
just,
true.
Yeah,
great. Thank you guys so much. Wonderful having you. And thank you to all my amazing guests today. I'm Lisa Oz, and I learned some great things today. I hope you did too.